You ready for some more terminology? Hooray! Vocab! We use the term design to describe the conceptual phase where a system architect establishes the pieces that will form the structure of the solution, develops the pipeline of elements solving the problem, or creates the architecture of components to deal with the problem. This phase is performed by the expert, the data scientist, engineers, modelers, software designers, architects, etc., whoever is building the model for their use. We use the term training in reference to the task of helping a model learn its world. In this phase, algorithms construct the model by learning, optimizing, simulating, and scaling. This phase is performed by the machine. The combination of designing a solution template and the computation of training produce a model of the world. Once the world is established, inference can be performed. Inference refers to operating a trained model in this world. Furthermore, inference is about exploiting this established world model. This can be done automatically by a computer system, interpreted by an expert, or any combination of both. As system architects, it's important to distinguish between the following phases. Phase 1. Design. Expert conceptualization of the problem and system architecture. Phase 2. Training. The computer operation and learning from data or simulating the problem. Phase 3. Inference. Computer operation in the real world based on learning. Let's go through a couple of examples of systems and the phases they involve. Consider for a moment a self-adaptive computing system that can adapt to failure conditions by learning and acting autonomously. It involves phase 1. The system is designed to self-configure, to self-protect from attack, to self-heal from faults, and to self-optimize its use of resources. It learns continuously on the job, which means that it may tend to be error-prone in early stages, but will get better over time. Keep in mind that situations that involve just one phase are rare. Most problems involve two phases. For example, data-driven problems tend to involve phases 2, learning, and phases 3, inference, with little design. If you want to forecast sales with historical sales data, that's a data-driven problem, and it will involve phases 2 and 3. Principle-driven problems tend to mostly involve phases 1, design, and phases 2, learning. For example, if you want to forecast how a new type of beverage dispenser would affect sales in a region, that's a principle-driven problem. If you want to forecast how a new type of packaging would affect product sales in a region, that's a knowledge-driven problem. Knowledge-driven problems tend to involve phases 1 and 3. Think back to our new and improved ABC Southern-style spicy watermelon Arnold Palmer example from earlier. Jeez, that's a mouthful. If only there was an algorithm that could truncate that name in an appealing way. Here are some exit notes. Large-scale problems involve all three phases due to their nature, and also because they can be structured into sub-problems that involve two phases. Think about our self-driving car model. Self-driving cars include significant design effort of the autonomous components, intensive model training and testing with a wide range of scenarios, and embedded inference in an autonomous system. In contrast to IT development, in hero development, there is an iterative process of model building driven by the problem, data, or knowledge. This proposed solution is refined, and its behavior is adapted by massively iterating computer executions. This process helps to establish the optimal parameters for the software to operate. Keep in mind the system architect's critical contribution to this process. Meanings of concepts are refined manually by an expert to resolve contradictions, breakdowns in logic, and avoid infinite loops. Designing, building, and testing is not enough. A model needs to be effectively created and fed all possible pertinent data to make it effective. Kato AI.